If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Last time we were working on our filament admin panel series, and I mentioned some issues that I was having with doing certain things. And one of those issues was dealing with the themes. So I went ahead and worked on it a little bit further after that video, and I managed to get it up and working. And it turns out I misplaced one single line. When we get to it, I will show you what it is. But for now, let's head over to the documentation. Over here in the filament documentation, if you go over to the admin panel and you go all the way down to where it says appearance, this is exactly where we are. So we're just going to go up here and take a look. Here are some different methods of changing things like the brand logo. You can change the dark mode, which we did in the, I believe it was the project setup episode when we worked on the config file. That's already done. But what I want to do is I want to go down to where it says building themes. Now, what it's saying here is that you want to install Tailwind and the forms and typography auto prefixer, which we already have. The only thing that we don't have is the tippy.js. So we're going to go ahead and install that first. Now, you can use whatever terminal you want to use. I'm going to be using the terminal that's built into VS Code. So I'm going to do npm install tippy.js, and then we'll do save dev. Let's go ahead, let that run, and head back to the documentation. So now if we go down a little bit, you see that in the config file, we need to bring in a few things. So one of them is the Tailwind CSS colors, and we're going to make sure that that's in the Tailwind config file. So let's copy that. And we can go ahead and just open it up and close this. We don't need that. And we can go ahead and bring it right under the default theme up here. And bring that down, and let's go back. So the next step is to, if you're going to be using the dark mode, we're going to need to bring in these classes. And this is the line that I actually put in the wrong spot before. I put it under the extend, which it's not supposed to be. It's supposed to be outside of the theme. So let's go ahead and add that as well. So now that's good. Let's go ahead and bring in some colors. Okay, and let's go ahead and bring that under the font family, and we should be good to go. So now you see we have danger, which the colors are rose. These are Tailwind colors. That's what this is letting you know, that we're bringing in the colors from up here and we're calling them down here. And these are Tailwind colors. So if you hover over them, you see the different ones that they are bringing in. So anything from 50 to 900. And that's pretty typical with Tailwind. We have the rose for danger, blue for primary, green for success, and yellow for warning. I will be changing some of these later to have my colors, but for now, this is a good start. We have these plugins required, but because we have Tailwind already, we already have it. So that's just this line right here. That's because we installed Tailwind. And if you didn't install Tailwind, then go ahead, install Tailwind, and make sure you have your setup like this. So let's head down and take a look here. Now it's saying you may specify your own colors, which will be used throughout the admin panel. So if you're using Veep, which we are, then we're going to bring this line into the CSS, and we also need to create this file as well. That's something that we need to bring in. And the other thing is to add Tailwind to the post CSS, which we already have because of the install that we did. So let's go ahead and bring this into the beat.js. Okay, and we just need to bring it under here. And then let's go ahead and also create this file. So in the resources CSS, right in here, we can just create a new file and we'll call it filament.css to match the file name that we just brought in. Okay, so let's head down. These are the instructions if you were using Laravel Mix, and this is just really to use the CSS from Filament as well as the Tailwind CSS to make sure that you require that. So that's if you're using Mix, but if you're not, then don't worry about this. But we do need to add this line to our new filament.css file. Go ahead, paste that in. So now you may register the theme file in a service provider into the boot method. So let's go ahead and grab that, and we'll put it in the service provider that we created. Okay, and we can just put it right under, we'll do it under here so that we still have it within the serving function and we can just register the theme. So now we need to also bring this in, and it will be the Illuminate Foundation V. What it's doing is it's registering the filament.css file that we created. So now that we have that done, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop the server. And then I'm going to restart it. And then we'll check our changes on the front end. So let's go ahead and refresh this. So now you see that orange button that we had here, that orangish color, is now blue because this is the primary color. In the tailwind.config.js, the primary color is blue. So that's why that color is now blue. And if we go ahead and drop that, you can see that this is now that bluish color, and we can still toggle the dark mode and we still have that blue in there. But what I want to do is I want to change this to be one of my colors, which would be green. So this primary one is now going to be green. And now the success will just be blue. And the yellow, I'm going to make it purple because that's not a color within Filament. I haven't had anything that I use have this warning class on it. This will be so that you'll know if something is purple, you'll know if you want to change it to a different color, you absolutely can, but at least you'll know what is attached to this warning class. Let's go ahead and take a look now. It auto-refreshed it, and this is now my color. Okay, and if you go here, you see that now this is green. If we put it in light mode, then I still have green. This is still green. Fantastic. If you go to another link, you see that that color is also green. These colors are now green and these colors are still the same. So let's go ahead and try to make a new permission and see we have green, green everywhere. Go ahead and create. Okay, now you see that that's blue instead of green where it was before, and that's our notification. So this is something that you can do for your colors. So now if we go ahead and change this back to dark mode and go ahead and log out, you see that we have this greenish color that I added, and this is part of that coloring. Now, if you want to add any other colors, you'll have a better idea of how to do it. I'm not sure that you can change these blues. This is the gray. I think it's Text Gray 900 that's coming in from Tailwind. But if we take a look, yeah, see BG Gray 100. These are other things that you can change, and that might be something that you can do in the filament.css. For now, I am happy that these colors are implemented and that looks a little bit more custom for you. At least you have some kind of idea of how to do it. If you want to do these a little bit further, then you can always reach out to the GitHub repo for Filament and ask them, how can you change this? If you can change it, that's something that you can do as well. If you're enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. Here's a video YouTube thinks you'll like, and here's a playlist to follow along. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.